per n, how many ways there are to tile. Every tiling is of one of two classes. Either the tiling is of the form where this is n long and the very last thing is a square. This is one category. There is another category of tilings where if I look at the very last thing, this is still n long, the last thing is actually a domino domino. Do you agree that every tiling which is allowed is either this or this? Can it be both? No. That's very important. Whenever I break into two pieces, I need to say it's always this or this, not both. But wait a second. Let's look at this one, so it's easier. If it's this kind, where I already know the last one is a square, how many ways can I finish it?
An
minus one ways. This is an exclamation point. I'll make it look better. And over here, if I take away the last two, it's an minus two ways. And therefore, this an is equal to an minus one plus an minus two. So we have just proven that it satisfies the Fibonacci recurrence, which is nice. And that shows why, you know, when you saw this pattern, it worked. I will say, this does not yet prove it's the Fibonacci sequence. I've proven that the recurrence holds. What else do I need to show that it's exactly the Fibonacci sequence? The first two, right? So the complete proof that this is Fibonacci is these two lines plus the recursion. And now it's Fibonacci, which is nice. And that's beautiful. Actually, I'll take a step back and I'll say, you know, there's a reason why you were taught Fibonacci sequences, probably. One is they're beautiful, of course. But the other is, did anyone tell you about nature and where you might see this? Can someone tell me where you see these
Fibonacci shapes?
Sorry?
Nautilus
shell. This thing, that's fine. What other places do you see these Fibonacci?
Mona Lisa.
Ah, it's like, perfect. Yeah. Sorry?
Human DNA,
okay, yeah. Fibonacci spiral, yes. And also, like, pineapples, yeah? All these natural things. Here's a question. Why is nature full of Fibonacci? Did anyone think about that? Is it, like, complete magic? Did anyone think of the theoretical reason? Why should it be that Fibonacci is everywhere in nature? Or is it just that way? If it's just that way, that's a pretty big coincidence. Because one is the pineapple, one is the nautilus shell. Last I knew, the two